somebody. Tell God, thank you. We come to celebrate. And before we go any further in this program, the celebration, we want to thank the Bishop Rogers, James Rogers, for opening his temple to this occasion. Let us give him a hand. Before we go any further, we want all the ministers of God, the suffering of God, ministers, wherever you at, to stand right now. Amen. We have a description in the Old Testament, Bishop James Rogers. In the New Testament, we have Reverend Jeanette Savage. The invocation, R.P. McKinley. We will come in that order. And after invocation, we have selection by Trinity Choir. Let us come in that order.
Says you are the strength of my life. What a fitting song. God is our strength. Psalms 91 says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadows of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder. The young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high because he has known my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I would be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. Last verse, with long life will I satisfy him and show him mine salvation. Psalms 91. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word. Family, we're praying for you. God bless you. From St. John. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that there I am, there ye may be also. And whether I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not whether thou goest, and how can we know the way? And Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. The word of God for all God's people. Amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we come this morning to tell you thank you. We thank you for your goodness, your mercy, your patience, and your long-suffering. For you said in your word that man should always pray and not faint. Lord, we come this morning to tell you thank you. Thank you that you've been good to us. You've been better to us than we've been to ourselves. We thank you for this family, friends, and loved ones, and acquaintances, and officials, and everyone that come to support this family. But Lord, we thank you that you gave your life for us, that we may have a right to the tree of life. We thank you that you sat on the throne and watched your son as he was beaten and bruised. Thank you that they buried him in a borrowed grave, but on that third day, he got up with all power in his hand. And because of that, this morning, we said thank you. Lord, Breonna is gone, but she can't crown him till we get there. So, Lord, we say thank you. We thank you for the life that the baby accepted you, and you accepted her. Lord, we thank you. Give this family the ability, the power to go through the storm. Let them be able to take the licking and keep on ticking. For you the one that paid the price for us out on that old rugged cross. And one of these old mornings, when it's all
got something here. I found the answer. How many know that Jesus is the answer? Come on, somebody. And I see down here 2 minutes. It say 2 minutes if I'm reading right. It say 2 minutes, please. And that's what your program say. Let us do it in order. Please, ma'am, and please, sir. And if you have your cellular phones on, please, ma'am, cut them off. Let us come as a friend, Jennifer Lee, if I'm reading that right. Let us come in order as the words of expression, as a friend, as a family member, and as a church member. Let us come in that order. All right? Because I don't want to mess names up.
To be shy before I met Breonna. I didn't like talking in front of people, but every day in ROTC someone had to get up and talk about anything motivational in front of class, and I would never get up, and Breonna would slap me in the arm in her definition of soft, which was completely different from mine, and make me get up and speak. And I was scared of her at first. But eventually it got to the point where I would get up every day and speak so I wouldn't get hit by Breonna. And I would say that's how me and Breonna became best friends. And Breonna, she saw something in me that I didn't see in myself. And when I lost my brother our junior year, Breonna will FaceTime me every day and just sit on the phone, try to make me laugh. And it didn't work at first, but she had that personality to where if Breonna tried to make you laugh, you would laugh. And what I would remember most about Breonna is her ability to be a friend to anyone she came in contact with. And she will be missed. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Breonna, one of Bree's friends. To my lovely friend, co-worker, and most of all, my big sister that I never had. It was a pleasure to have known such a caring, loving, and individual with great humor. You were someone who knew what they wanted in life and never gave up on it. One of the biggest things you wanted was to make Sergeant Moffett, and God made things work out in your favor. It was so bittersweet and hurtful that we can't celebrate on this side, but I know you're celebrating on the other side. I want to thank you for serving for our country. Now take your rest, big sis. Know that you will never be forgotten and always have a special heart, a special place in my heart. Love, love, Bree.
Special. She always made me smile. Even though we stayed 8 hours away in Mississippi, we stayed in contact a lot. You helped me through a lot over the phone. And when we was together, the Uno game would turn to a wrestling match real quick. We was always tussling. And we was always outgoing. Anything she wanted, she earned it. She would go get it. She was my favorite cousin. We always used to talk all the time. Every time she called, like, Mar, I got some tea. We always used to talk about something. I remember us growing up, going to Aunt Kathy's house, Granny Kathy's house, calling cows. Be in the country somewhere acting the fool. And she used to make sure everybody was straight. She used to put others in front of her sometimes a lot. She used to make sure everybody that she loved was straight. I was on my lowest. Gave me words of encouragement. Gave me advice when I need it. You gave me a little cash when I need it. I just wanted to say, Breonna is the most brilliant person I ever met. I love all y'all. Everybody who came today, God bless y'all. Thank you.
Breonna came to Trinity as a baby. She wasn't even a year old when she first started coming to Trinity. And she was, as she grew, she became a real faithful member. She was there, and anytime you needed her for anything, she would do it. No matter what you asked her to do, she would do it. She was a part of the usher board, and she ran that usher board. Even if the director wasn't there, she made sure that everybody was on pulse, doing their own thing and whatever they had. We had a band in the church. She also was a member of that, and she was a member of one of the choirs. She was just an all-around person. No matter what you thought about her, you were wrong, because she never did any wrong in my sight. And I was just, you know, glad to be a part of her life and understanding that no matter what you do, long as you do it for the Lord, that everything will work out all right. Thank you.
This is from all of us to our cousin Breonna. You were someone that we could all look up to because you were so steadfast and hardworking. You were able to accomplish so much in a short time. You made us proud when you decided to join the military, and we have many family members that were in the military, and you were the first of our generation that made that decision. We appreciate your dedication and service to our family and country. You are the epitome of what family means. You love your family to no end. You are very outspoken, always speaking your mind and telling it how it is. You are such a loving and caring person with a big personality to match, and you are also super funny. It was easy for us to grab gravitate to you. We all live far apart, but when it was time for us to get together, it was always a vibe, real conversations, and endless laughter. Breonna loved her family from the oldest to the youngest. As cousins, we started making plans for when we wanted to meet up again, but unfortunately, that time never came. It's so important to be intentional about spending time with each other. We're so used to saying, I'll see you next time, not knowing when it's the last. As cousins, we might want to make it a point to spend more time together and continue cultivating memories. We love you, Bree, and we know you'll always be watching over us. With much love.
Say thank you to the family for allowing me this selfish moment. The worst words is what if, what could have been, or what was. That's not associated with Breonna, because Breonna is what is. She was what was, and she will forever be more. I work with youth a lot, and so often we hear people talk about how selfish our youth are. They only think about themselves. They only do things so that they can gain what they want. That was not Breonna at all. Breonna gave to her family love. She gave to her neighborhood a friend. She gave to her community a hero. And she gave to our nation a debt that they will never be able to repair. When I first heard about her passing, I was hoping it was a mistake. I was hoping somewhere between the messages getting relayed, it wasn't her at all. But I had to rely on my faith. I grew up in Ridgeville, South Carolina, and my mother and my father had me in church every day. Every day. And one thing I learned from going to church so much is that there's a battle between good and evil. And that battle is here on earth. But it's also a spiritual battle. And at times, our Father God, he needs soldiers to help him in that spiritual battle. And we don't like to lose earthly people because they mean so much to us. But God needed Breonna. He needed that young, energetic soul to help him with that spiritual battle. So going forward, it's okay to miss Breonna. It's okay to be sad. But just know she's doing what she's always did for all of us. She's fighting that spiritual battle. She's making sure that when we get there, things will be good. So every day from here on out, allow Breonna's spirit to live through all of us. Be patient like she was. Be loving like she was. Be caring like she was. And don't do it just for a day. Don't do it just for a week. Don't do it just for a year. Do it until you see Breonna on the other side.
First and foremost, I would like to thank the Moffett family for allowing me to speak. Their strength and resilience in the face of such tragedy has been both inspiring and motivating. I'm Sergeant First Class Kevin Gupton. I have the honor and privilege of being Sergeant. Sergeant Moffett was an incredible young lady with a remarkable future ahead of her. She always went above and beyond in everything that she did. He was a driven, natural leader. And I say that because as a leader, one of the biggest challenges you face is to lead amongst your peers. He operated in that space seamlessly, from JROTC, being a drum major in Windsor Forest, entrepreneurship, and the social settings. He had a natural ability to lead effortlessly and make everyone around her still feel seen and heard. I never once heard or saw her be condescending or unsure. I knew then she was special. She came to me and expressed interest in the Army. She proudly informed me that her mom had served. She was so proud to be following in her mom's footsteps, and I was equally excited for her because it was something that she was passionate about. I knew she would be great. Not because she was respectful, came from an outstanding family, and was self-motivated to be great. I knew she would be great because she naturally possessed a trait that often eludes the best of us. That trait is selflessness. This attribute is an essential pillar taught to soldiers in our institutional domain. However, Sergeant Moffett naturally possessed it. This speaks volumes about her character and the environment in which it was shaped and cultivated. When so much of today's social construct enables you to grab hold of something that allows you to be selfish, he grabbed a pen and signed to support and defend the Constitution. He truly represents and embodies the best our nation has to offer. Over the last week, I've heard countless stories shared from multiple perspectives about her willingness to be selfless, continue to lead by helping out with her high school band and her free time. All these stories only confirmed what I know in my heart to be true. Breonna Moffett was one of a kind. On top of being optimal in all she did, she managed also to be a great daughter, sister, friend, and mentor in her community. I can go on and on about what type of person Sergeant Breonna Moffett was, but I'll close with two things. After she had joined and signed her contract, there is always a ton of excitement, and rightfully so. Before she left my office, she turned to me and says, "Thank you, Sergeant Guptill." And I looked at her and smiled, said what I've told anyone I've ever put in the Army. "You're welcome, and I appreciate it. Don't thank me with your words. Thank me by pouring into the person coming after you and going forward and continuing to do great things." Being the overachiever she was, she went forward and became a true American hero. We will never forget you, and our legacy will live through all the people you've touched and impacted. Lastly, I want to challenge the community, everyone who can hear the sound of my voice, to continue to support the Moffett family and shower them with whatever they need as they grieve. May God provide you with his perfect peace. I typically close with a quote, somebody way more important to me, somebody someone can look up to and hold on to. No one is more fitting than the Moffett family. So I'll end with a quote from Mrs. Moffett. Enjoy life while you're here. Enjoy your kids while you're here. Enjoy your parents while you're here. Because you just never know when you'll get that phone call. Mrs. Francine Moffett. Thank you.
Good morning. That's the Moffett family. As you mourn the loss of Breonna, I thank you for the opportunity to speak. I only hope my words help in honoring her legacy as a soldier and her memory as an outstanding young woman who was taken from us too soon. I'd also like to acknowledge Governor and First Lady Kemp, our distinguished state and local representatives who are here today, Mayor Johnson, law enforcement, first responders, military veterans, friends and family. Thank you for being here to pay respects to our fallen hero, Sergeant Moffett. As soldiers, we rally to the ethic of the Army, which includes values of loyalty, duty, respect, honor, integrity, and personal courage. We believe these are essential to our profession. And Sergeant Moffett, as a dedicated, proud soldier, exemplified these values. When enlisting, soldiers take an oath to support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic, and to bear true faith and allegiance to the same. Sergeant Moffett honored her oath to the fullest measure. And while these vows are central to our profession, it does take more to be a soldier. We want soldiers to be balanced find balance that keeps a healthy family life and a healthy spiritual life. And here in particular, Sergeant Moffett was an example to us all, where she showed us how to prioritize and commit to her family and her faith, even while deployed. So what does that mean for us? I'll go back in history a little bit. In late November of 1863, President Lincoln traveled to Gettysburg, Pennsylvania to give an address. Many of us know by its opening words, 67 years ago. But what many do not know, or maybe you've just forgotten, is that the Gettysburg Address was a speech given 4 months after the battle at Gettysburg. And President Lincoln went to Gettysburg to dedicate the Soldiers' National Cemetery. And in that speech, President Lincoln referred to the United States as a nation conceived in liberty. And he pressed the crowd to a great task, saying, "From these honored dead, we take increased devotion to that cause. For which they gave the last full measure, that last measure of devotion. That we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain. That this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom. And that government by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth. To the Moffett family, I want you to know that we recognize the legacy of Sergeant Moffett as an outstanding soldier, and we will ensure we remember and honor that legacy. It is difficult to accept the loss of a single soldier, particularly one so exceptional as Sergeant Moffett, but she died for her nation. And I hope we find some solace in that and use it to further inspire all of us to be better, to be balanced, courageous, dedicated to service, faithful, and loved.
Now we have upon my sister Regina Moffett. We'll come now with a poem.
One of my memories of her and her sisters 15 months apart. And I remember one morning I told my husband, I'm like, I don't know why our second baby is never wet, because she was like just a few months old. I'm like, she's always dry when I wake up. I'm like, I know she's not potty training right now. She's only 3 months old. And so we snuck around the corner one morning, and Breonna, being Breonna, she was pulling her out of the crib, and she would take her upstairs and she would push her on the couch, and she just changed her diaper. I've never taught her this, but she just changed her diaper. She just go in there and she make a bottle, and she just give her cup or her bottle, and she's just always just been a mama figure. So I always knew that she just be Breonna and be strong-willed. So my poem for my baby today is Only If. Only if my heart could speak the words that my mouth could not say. Only if my ears could hear your laughter another day. Only if my eyes could see you walk through my front door and you look my way once more. Only if my arms could hug you tight and never let you go. Only if my legs could chase you so. Only if my lips could say, I love you once more. I know my soul would never be healed like it should. But I just want to say to my sergeant, to my baby, to my firstborn, that I will always love you, honor you, and cherish you. You are my sergeant, my
We now will have a music tribute. We can use the mic.
Good afternoon. Can I please have all the Windsor Forest Knights stand up if you're in the house? All the Windsor Forest Knights. Breonna, as you know, was a drum major in the band, but she also was a leader in ROTC. So Bree, from everybody in life that you touch in high school, we love you. For me personally, I love you. You taught me how to lead. But we love you. We're gonna miss you. Thank y'all. It's also the tribute from Mr. Johnson, our band director, me, assistant drum major, and thank you, Mr. Kenyatta Tucker from Johnson for helping us. Thank y'all.
Wow. While Isaiah goes get set up for the drums, I just wanted to say that Breonna was my first leader here when I moved to Savannah, Georgia. She was a drum major by herself for a while. And she used to go out there and march, you know, in that band, lead that band by herself, you know, and never did it before as by herself, but she had no fear. And I remember, you know, Isaiah was one of her best friends. So she and I discussed bringing him into the drum major scene because he seemed like a really good candidate. And we did pretty good together as a family. And just to my Moffett family, we love you guys, you know, so we're here.
city of Savannah, Governor Bryant Kemp, state of Georgia, Chairman Chester A. Ellison, Chatham County Board of Commission. Let us come in that order, please.
Like a comet blazing across the evening sky, gone too soon. Like a rainbow fading in the twinkling of an eye, gone too soon. Shiny and sparkly and splendidly bright, here one day, gone one night. Like the loss of sunlight on a cloudy afternoon, gone too soon. Bishop and Dr. Rogers, thank you again for allowing us use of your beautiful sanctuary. To Pastor Molly, to all of the here, Reverend Tate, particularly to our governor and First Lady, Brian and Marty Kemp. Let's give them a round of applause as well. And for Speaker and Mrs. Burns, this has been a particularly trying time in our state over the last couple of days, particularly with the loss of these three heroes and a trooper, and they have traversed the state back and forth to be of support, and so we certainly appreciate them being here with us. To our 65th mayor of the city of Savannah, Edna Branch Jackson, who is here, Representative Edna Branch Jackson. And to the members of the Savannah City Council, if you're here, if you would please stand. Alderwoman Shabazz, Alderman Leggett, and Alderwoman Carol Bell, who provided a valuable service helping us coordinate it. Thank you so much. And to all elected servants that are here, if you would please stand as well. Make sure the family knows you're here. If you're elected anywhere, just stand. And also particularly good to see our friend Chairman Donald Lovett of the Liberty County Board of Commissioners here with us as well. But particularly to this family, Purcell, Regina, Kiana, Purcell, Anika, this amazing family. Let's show them some love. I think we could do a little bit better than that, right? I think we can do a little bit better than that. Our nation and our state was traumatized by the loss of three great Americans, three great Georgians. And for us, a community that is known and renowned for military service, this one was different. This one struck deeper. This one hit harder because this was one of our very own. And in the ensuing days, while we were trying to make sense out of senselessness and trying to figure out why good things, bad things happen to good people. While we continue to celebrate the many men and women of our various conflicts and those who have lost their lives and those who've returned home, here today we have a new definition of hero, a new generation of hero. An And if you Google it, I'm certain that it will show Sergeant Breonna Moffett. Somebody should give God some praise for that. This beautiful lady, this born leader, JROTC leader, drum major at the Windsor Forest High School. Windsor Forest, that's your point too. At the Windsor Forest High School. All right. Who at 17 made the mature decision? Where others her age are trying to still figure stuff out, Breonna raised her hand, stepped forward to serve her country. And she did. And she did it in such a major way. Being promoted, loving her family, serving her state, and serving her nation. And although we can't make sense of what's happened, we certainly can salute her for what she has done. We are reminded that there is no greater love than a man or a woman who lays down their life for a friend. And so every single day, those that put on uniforms, put them on and understand whether you're in the military or in law enforcement, you understand very clearly what the assignment is. And you understand very clearly what the assignment can be. And she did it anyway. And so we love her and we salute her, whether we knew her or not, just for being able to step forward. And so I've had the opportunity to spend time with this magnificent family, this loving family, this caring family, that for us is a hero, but for them it's their little girl. It's their big sister. And so for them, it is much more personal, which is why it's so important for this community to continue to show love for Breonna by showing love for her family. Because days like this end, but the loss will always be there. And we're going to find a way to really show love in a more meaningful and lasting way. And when we do, and we make the call, we trust that Savannah will respond as we always do. Her mom told me that Breonna wanted to be promoted from specialist to sergeant. And that happened, Sergeant Moffett. But I submit to you that there's been more promotions. She's been promoted from labor to reward. She's been promoted from extraordinary to legend. She's been promoted from time to eternity. And I wasn't in the military, but I believe that she's been properly relieved from her duties on this side by the commanding officer who does all things well. And this commanding officer on high has assigned her to now special duty in glory, where Bishop Sills, I'm told the streets are paved in gold, where I'm told the wicked cease from troubling, where I'm told that the weary souls will be at rest. I'm told that now this special duty includes watching over you, interceding for you, making sure that you're going to be all right, because God never takes away without adding to. So God is going to add more because of what you have lost. So I want you to know that this city loves you. We appreciate you. And we ain't going nowhere. You stuck with us. I told you that. So lock us in. The Savannah City Council approved on the 8th of February a resolution that I won't read in its entirety, but it is the desire of this body that the deep sympathy of all our people be expressed to the family of Sergeant Moffett. Her loved ones will always remember her for her style, her smile, and her generosity. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the mayor and aldermen of the city of Savannah celebrate the life and service of Sergeant Moffett, and that a copy of this resolution be delivered to the family of Sergeant Breonna Alexandra Moffett with the prayer that the sacrifice of this brave young woman will not be in vain, but that democracy will survive and peace be restored to our world. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution will be made a part of the permanent records of the Savannah City Council and witness wherever I have hereto set my hand and cause the seal of the city of Savannah to be affixed on this day. God bless you. God be with you. God be with all of us. Thank you for this legend.
Thank you, Mayor. I come to you today on behalf of a grateful state for Breonna Moffett's service and ultimate sacrifice. Today is truly a heartbreaking day for this family, for the people of this city, for this state, and for this nation. Along with Speaker John Burns and Mrs. Dale Burns, the First Lady of Georgia, Marty Kemp, and myself, Represented Gilliard, Representative Jackson. Today we honor another of our fallen heroes, a daughter, a sister, a loved one, a friend, a woman who chose a career and a life of service, and a beloved Georgian. When someone is taken from us so young in this life, as Breonna was, and in such a painful way, we are all immediately stuck with grief. The souls of those who loved her most are made to ache in such a way that words cannot describe. And we are left searching for the meaning behind this agonizing loss. In truth, there is nothing we can say here today that will mend the broken hearts left in the wake of this tragedy. And there is no answer on this side of heaven that will provide the reason for which we seek. But in spite of all the heartbreak around us in this place of worship, despite the unmet searching, I am reminded of two things shared by Sergeant Moffett's family after learning of her death. Her mother said, "We weren't there, but she knew we loved her." Her parents went on to say that they are a faith-filled family who believe in God wholeheartedly and always have. Miss Moffett said, "We always raised our kids to believe in God, to put God first, and I would always say to Breonna, make sure you put God first." And she would say, "You don't have to tell me that because I do it every single day." What a beautiful profession of a family's love for each other and of their faith, a faith that gives us some comfort in these moments of grief. Because although we do not know why Breonna was taken from us so young, we do know that she is in a better place where there is no grief, no suffering, nor any sadness at all. Romans chapter 14, verse 8 tells us, "If we live, we live for the Lord. If we die, we die for the Lord. So whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord." Sergeant Breonna Moffett lived and died for the Lord and for our country. And in giving the last full measure of devotion and service to this nation, she has ensured that her name will live on forever as one of our honored fallen and someone our hearts and memories will not forget. Breonna belongs to the Lord, and that is who she is at this very moment. And we are thankful for that knowledge. And we will carry it with us as we continue to grieve her passing. To the entire Moffett family, please know that all of Georgia mourns you with you today. And Marty and the girls and I will continue to pray for you all during this difficult time. as you bear the weight of her loss, please know you do not bear it alone. May God bless the Moffett family. May he bless those who served alongside Breonna, as well as Sergeant William Jerome Rivers and Sergeant Kennedy Sanders. And may he comfort the grieving hearts of all Georgians on this day of sadness with the hope and peace that only God's love can provide. I now give you the Honorable Chester Ellis.
Bishop Rogers, that's a take. To the governor, the speaker, the first ladies, the mayor, the state representatives, the pastors, officers, and members who are gathered here with us, to all of those in uniform whose service we cherish, and we say thank you. With me, I saw earlier, commissioners, what you saying? Commissioner Hodge, Commissioner Stone, Commissioner Lockett, family, we want you to know we hurt because you hurt. Earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. And though Breonna will be absent from this body, she will be present with the Lord. Her service down here represents her service on the other side. And so, on behalf of the County of Chatham, Georgia, this resolution from the Board of Commissioners in memory and of the sacrifice that Sergeant Moffett gave to us to keep us safe. Now, therefore, be it resolved that I, Chester Ellis, Chairman of the Chatham County Board of Commissioners, do humbly submit this resolution as a tribute to the memory of Sergeant Moffett, who made the ultimate sacrifice. In witness whereof, I hereto set my hands and cause the seal of Chatham County, Georgia, to be affixed this 17th day of February 2024. The president has the Congressional Medal of Honor that he can bestow upon citizens. Here in Chatham County, we have two medals that we present to families. And I want to make sure that you know that Breonna will always be in our hearts. She will always be a part of the record of Chatham County. So I did not read this whole thing because it mirrors what the governor and what the mayor has already said about the state of Georgia, the county of Chatham, and the city of Savannah. But I do want to present you with these medals that come from the county, so that as you sit and as you go through precious memories, because precious memories linger, late in the night, early in the morning, in the midst of the day. because of her sacrifice, we all sleep better at night. And because she gave the love that God says that no man has except he who gives to his brother, the love and the sacrifice that she laid down her life, knowing the dangers that she faced, yet she was willing to step up and step forward. And so we say to you today, rejoice, rejoice in knowing that she may be absent from this body, but she is present with the Lord. The Honorable Carl Gilliard.
To the Moffett family, to the family of all that are in the Trinity family, in the presence of my governor and first lady, in the presence of my speaker and first lady, and in the presence of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I come to you as the chairman of the Georgia Legislative Black Caucus, representing 74 state representatives and senators, to tell you, the Moffett family, that we are with you on today. The drum major for freedom has taken her rest, but the drum major for freedom has designed a cadence today that is beating all over this nation, that on January the 28th, the weapons formed, but they did not prosper. The weapons formed, but freedom rang a mighty tone for such a mighty soldier, such a mighty freedom fighter. To all of the young people that are here today that knew Breonna, would you stand? You see, they're marching through the cadences of these new leaders. You cannot stop the rhythm of this band. You cannot stop the rhythm of freedom. On this defining day, I challenge you with this resolution to keep the cadences going. Amen. And to the men and women of the United States of America that you serve in our armed forces, would you stand, the men and women? Dr. King talked about the drum major for justice. Thank you for being the drum major for freedom with Sergeant Moffett. And though we've had several resolutions to the family, as we give you and mark this as a resolution that is a law in the state of Georgia, that you can go back to the records for the rest of your life to make this a committed testimony of the life of your daughter. But I leave you with this from just a young Hazard County boy. When you talk about freedom, it's like a song from the civil rights movement that many of you know. It says, oh, oh, freedom. Oh, freedom. Oh, freedom over me. I'd be a to my Lord and be free. No more pain, no more pain. Will you sing it with me? No. Sergeant Moffett, let freedom ring. Amen. To Governor Kemp and the representatives who are here, Speaker Burns, who's here, to Chairman Ellis and our commissioners who are here, to Mayor Johnson and our representatives who are here, to our men and women in uniform, we thank you for your service. To our troopers, we stand with you as you always stand with us. My name is Andrew Young. I am here on behalf of our United States Senator, Reverend Raphael Warnock. Senator Warnock could not be here. Amen. One of Savannah's own. Amen. The senator could not be here, but he wanted to be sure that the Moffett family knew of his both care, concern, and his unwavering support for you. So he sent this letter, part of which I will read now, and I will give you a copy of the entire letter. Dear Purcell and Francine, please accept my sincere and heartfelt condolences regarding the tragic loss of your daughter, Breonna. I know there are no words that can provide true solace in this moment, but during this time of grieving, please know your state and your nation mourn with you and are lifting you up in love and prayer as we come together to honor Breonna's life and selfless sacrifice. As a sergeant in the Army Reserve, she exemplified a work ethic and skill that is rare and remarkable. Georgians and Americans nationwide are indebted to your family and Breonna, and I cannot overstate my own gratitude and respect. Scripture reminds us in Lamentations 3:32, though he brings grief, he will show compassion. So great is his unfailing love. I pray you will hold this promise close to your heart, trusting that Breonna's spirit will be with you until you are reunited once again. And finally, the senator writes, please know you have a champion in me and that you will remain in my prayers. Do not hesitate to reach out to my office if I can ever be of any service to you. Keep the faith. Signed, Reverend Raphael Warnock, United States Senator, Georgia. God bless you. Our prayers and support and hands are with you.
Johnson, Brad Kemp, State of Georgia, Chester Ellis, and Andrew Young. We're going to have now our acknowledgement, Deaconess Trudell, Revolution, Tiana, Odictionary, Reed Silas. Then we'll have a selection from the choir. Then the next voice you hear is no other than Reverend Earl Tate III. When he comes, he needs your prayers. I know he have a word to tell us from the Lord. So let us come that way.
God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, and for whosoever believe in him shall not perish but have eternal life. I love Breonna, Kiana. It was just us three, Breonna, Kiana, Tiana. Always, I love you. Dear Mr. and Mrs. Moffett, on behalf of the combined joint task force, Operation Inherent Resolve, it is with great sadness that I offer my condolences to you, your family, and your community as we mourn the tragic loss of your daughter, Sergeant Breonna Moffett. Despite the pain you feel from her absence and the void it's created in your lives, know that I and everyone who knew her will do our very best to live in a way that pays tribute to Breonna's memory and sacrifice. When called upon, she volunteered and said, "Send me." She lived her life in a way that will serve as an enduring beacon for those that wish to follow in the footsteps of a hero. Breonna represents the best of America. Please note that we will honor Sergeant Moffett and your family's sacrifice as we pay our final respects to your daughter and our fallen friend. Breonna will be missed by all of us, but never forgotten. Sincerely, J.B. Vowell, Major General, U.S. Army Commanding. No one can say they know what you're going through right now. May God watch over your family in your time of need. A wounded heart will heal in time. And when it does, the memory and love of our loved ones are sealed inside to comfort us. Valentina Hardin, Navy Grandma. Praying God will show you his love through caring friends, comforting memories, and moments of peace. Praying he will give you whatever your heart needs the most right now. Sincerely, Julie Penny. Thinking of you at this difficult time, may all the warm and special memories you share with your loved one stay with you and bring you comfort through all the days ahead. With love, Dr. Naletta Hamill.
Will the Veterans of Foreign Wars members please stand? Veterans of Foreign Wars of the United States, Memorial Commendation presented in memory of Specialist Breonna Alexandria Moffett, whose devotion to duty, courage, and patriotism has been so boldly evidenced by the selfless service and supreme sacrifice in defending the freedoms of an oppressed people and ensuring the security of all Americans. SPC Moffett's sacrifice will forever be remembered and honored by those who share the common bond of service under the flag of the United States. In witness whereof, we have hereunto set our hands and the official seal of the Veterans of Foreign Wars of the United States. Commanding Chief Duane Sarianto, Adjutant General D. West. Thank you. Resolution. Honoring the life and memory of Sergeant Breonna Alexandria Moffett and for other purposes. Whereas the state of Georgia mourns the loss of one of its most notable patriotic and selfless citizens with the passing of Sergeant Breonna Alexandria Moffett. And whereas Sergeant Moffett was born on January 20th, 2021, and from a young age she exhibited remarkable intelligence and drive, learning to read by the age of 3, and later joining the gifted program at Windsor Forest Elementary School. And whereas Sergeant Moffett grew a highly competitive individual, engaging in sports
such as soccer and baseball, and joining the band in fifth grade. And whereas continuing her pursuit of excellence, Sergeant Moffett was part of the Junior ROTC and Marching Knights Band at Windsor Forest High School, where she earned numerous accolades and reached the role of drum major in her senior year. And whereas Sergeant Moffett served as a guardian of this nation's freedom and liberty, beginning with her service in the Army Reserves at the age of 17. And whereas Sergeant Moffett was a compassionate and courageous woman who will long be remembered for her love of family and friends, her laughter and smile, and her deep faith in the glory of God. And whereas she was a person of magnanimous strength with an unimpeachable reputation for integrity, intelligence, fairness, and kindness. By the example she made of her life, she made this world a better place in which to live. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Senate that the members of this body join in honoring the life and memory of Sergeant Breonna Alexandria Moffett and express their deepest and most sincere regret at her passing. Be it further resolved that the Secretary of State is authorized and directed to make an appropriate copy of this resolution available for distribution to the family of Sergeant Breonna Alexandria Moffett. So resolved, the 17th day of February, 2024, Senator Derek Marlow, District 2. Trinity Foundation Missionary Baptist Church, 5129 Simpson Street, Savannah, Georgia, 31405. Resolution in loving memory of Breonna Moffett. Though your days among us were too brief, and our grief at your loss is never ending, we draw comfort from the knowledge that you have found safe refuge in the Lord, and in our hearts, where no darkness or pain can touch you now. Whereas Breonna Moffett passed from this life on Sunday, January 28, 2024, we believe she made her peace with the Lord and now rests with him for eternity. Whereas Breonna was a faithful member of Trinity Foundation Missionary Baptist Church, served on the usher board, a member of the New Direction Choir, a dance group, the church band, and a Bible study scholar. Whereas Breonna was the cherished daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Bernard Moffett and the proud older sibling of Kiana, Purcell, and Anika. Whereas we have all been blessed by her presence because of her quiet and mild spirit. To Brother Moffett and Sister Moffett, Kiana, Purcell, Anika, Little Jeremiah, and the other family members, Trinity Foundation Missionary Baptist Church extends a sincere sympathy and will be fervently praying for and with you during this time of healing. We commend to you Jesus, knowing that God is able. May God continue to bless you and keep you. All you need, God will provide. Nothing you ask for will be denied. Lean weary ones upon his breast. He alone can give you peace and rest. The Lord our God will take care of you.
resolve that this resolution is given to the family, a copy kept in the church archives, humbly and prayerfully submitted by order of Trinity Foundation Missionary Baptist Church, 5129 Simpson Street, Savannah, Georgia, on the 17th day of February, 2024. Interim spiritual leader, Reverend Jeanette Frazier Savage. Thank you.
Giving honor to God who's ahead of my life that allowed me to get up today. Amen. I know we're here for a memorial, but at this time, I'd like to honor Sergeant. I feel like everybody should be smiling because that's what she did. I understand the family, but we must carry her smile on. So I'd like everybody to smile right now. Our Breonna. Giving honor to all the officials that came before me, everybody in the audience, military, officer, and truly this family. But at this time, I'd like to show y'all another part of her family. Trinity Foundation, will y'all stand? Her pastor, will you stand? Pastor Hal P. McKinley. Her grandpa, Miley. Amen. I feel like it was so many eulogies before I came up here. So I said, the next time if I ever run across a person that's honored like her, I'm going to write it myself and I'm going to speak first. Because I just heard everything, but I just have a question. Did she ever go to the playground? She truly a remarkable woman whom I have the pleasure of being in her presence. I know that a lot of time I was supposed to be the adult, but she carried her life. A lot of times she was the adult to me. Amen. But I know we're here for a celebration, but I just like everybody to give God thanks. Thanks for a woman of courage. Thank you for a vessel of the Lord. Amen. Thank you for somebody that found it not robbing to go out and serve the country for our lives. Amen. Word says, if it wasn't for the Lord on my side, where would I be? And she lives by that. She honored those words because she kept the Lord on her side. She walked with the Lord every day. This I know. I ain't telling you what nobody told me, but this I know. We talking about a young woman that, despite whatever she was going through, she always had a smile for everybody else. She always had a smile on her face. And as I was listening to everybody talk, I was trying to think, have I ever seen a man? If she was, her parents made her straighten up her face before she got to church. Because when she walked in that door, it was all about the Lord's business, amen? She's going to be truly missed. By the way, I won't be before you long. It has been a while, and I know the family ready to get to themselves. Amen? But when I think about Sergeant Breonna, and I read the obituary and looked at her age, it's often that she'll make you forget how old she was because of the way she carried her life. Now, this is no slam to no young person in here, but she carried herself as her age group. She didn't live a fast life. She used a choice life, a life that her mother and her father chose for her, and she found it not robbing to obey. So I say this to every young person in here. At this time, you have an idol, someone who you can live your life behind, someone that you can decide to give yourself to the Lord as she have did, because she lived a good life. She didn't live a short life. She lived a good life, and we can't take that from her. But she lived that life because an old saying says that the apple don't fall far from the tree. So that tells me something great about this family, that they have a whole bunch of good apples on this tree. Amen? And I love them for that. I love them for the way that they raised her. I love them for the way that they didn't cheat me out of my life and allow her to be in my presence. Not me in her presence, but her in my presence. She was truly a good woman. Proverbs 22:6 say, train up a child in the way that she should go. And when she grow old, she won't fall far from the word. Amen. I altered a little bit because we're talking about my sister here. She was truly a blessed person. Let us pray. Dear Lord of us all, we give thee thanks for the life of the one who has been taken from us, for what she has meant to the loving family and friends. We ask that you comfort the Moffett family. Give them strength. We give thanks for the love of God and for the salvation that is freely offered to us by Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I know that we love Breonna, but it's one thing that we must remember. God loved her first. God loved her first. We know that a lot of us go through affliction, but we also got to understand that the Lord delivered us from them all. Now, for some of us, deliverance is why we're here on this earth. Lord, will you deliver me out of this relationship? Will you deliver me for what I'm going through? Will you deliver me from this job? But deliverance from God is a seat on his right-hand side. And that's where she's seated at. On God's right-hand side, because she chose to walk the walk of a Christian, because she chose to walk the way that she supposed to walk, amen? And because she accepted God into her life at such an early age that she's able to sit on God's right-hand side. So I say to you, if you want to sit on God's right-hand side or you want to see her again, get your life right with God. Line your life up the way she lined her life up, and you can see her again. Maybe not on this side, but on the other side, where we all should desire to go. But family, I want you to know that you have not lost anything. God is holding her for you. God is protecting her for you. Because of the walk that you walk, you will always be with her. She's just sitting on God's right-hand side waiting on you. So I ask you to keep that walk of faith that you keep. Keep that journey that you are going on and never look back. Never let this day turn your life in any other direction but in the direction that it's going. Because John 3:16 says, like Tiana said, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son so that Breonna may live forever. We know it hurt. We know it's a sad. But we also know victory has just begun. Victory has just been won. Victory will carry you on. Keep victory in front and don't worry about nothing in the back. Because Breonna was a soldier in the Army. She was a soldier in the ROTC. Before y'all got her, the Lord had her. She was a soldier for the Lord. I can think back to days when her and Tiana, and her sister get up there in that praise dance and that hell go to flying and she go to dance, and I don't know if she was dancing or giving a sermon. But that what inspired me to let her mother trick me to dance for once. But we had a great time here at Trinity, and we love Breonna. And Breonna's one of our own. She will always be. So I just ask that you just continue to raise her siblings to follow in her footsteps. You have a beautiful family. And we appreciate all y'all coming and celebrating with us. But Breonna is one of a kind. There will never, ever be another Breonna. And we just thank the Lord for sending her our way. We thank the Lord for all the lessons that she have gave out, because I think she was put here to touch many lives of our young people, our youth. And I think she did her job and more. She went the extra mile. She did everything that it took to please God and then to please her family. We just give you thanks, Lord, for allowing us to be in her presence. I say I won't keep you long for y'all to go be by yourself, so at this time we'll do our committal. For as much as it hath pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world unto himself the soul of our deceased sister, we therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Oh, Heavenly Father, we just come together to say thanks. Thank you for allowing us to have her on this side for yet a moment. But Father, we ask that you touch this family. Give them strength. Give them courage. Give them whatever it takes for them to carry on, Father. We ask that you just comfort their soul, their mind, and their body. In Jesus' name, we pray. The grace of God, our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all and forevermore.
On behalf of Campbell and Sons Funeral Home, we would like to thank all the friends and loved ones online for all acts of kindness shown. To the family, thank you so much for entrusting your beautiful loved one with us. At this time, we would like all pallbearers to report up front, down to my far right, please.